Hi, and welcome to this Tech Insights video. My name is Mary, and I'm an application engineer here at IFM Effector. You are here because you have either purchased or plan to purchase an SM series flow sensor. In today's video, we are going to go over the programming of our SM series flow sensors. So let's get started. So here you have the Learn More section on our website for our SM series flow sensors. Under Setup and Support is where you can find helpful information in getting your sensor set up. In today's video, I am specifically going over the programming of our SM series flow sensors. So before I go to the sensor itself and show you how to manually program it using the display and push buttons, I wanted to show you this section in the Learn More page. Here, we have some definitions of different commonly used terms for parameters in our menu structure. For example, we explain the hysteresis normally open and hysteresis normally closed outputs, as well as the window function normally open and window function normally closed outputs, as well as going over what ASP and AEP mean in terms of the analog output. So now let me take you to the sensor itself and show you how to manually program it using the display and push buttons. In this video, I'm using the SM6020. This specific part number has a G1/2-inch process connection. However, there are other options available in different sizes and with different process connections. Here you have the colored display of our SM sensors. On this display, you can see you have the flow rate, temperature, and totalized value all on the display at once, and this is configurable. So in this video, I'm first going to show you how to change your display units, and then I'm going to take you into the Output 1 and Output 2 menus and show you how to set those parameters as well. So to begin to get into the menu, you press this Enter button. Here you see your main menu with your SP1, RP1, ASP2, and AEP2 parameters. If we go down to EF for extended functions and press Enter, it'll take you into the extended functions menu. The first thing you see is RES, which is where you can factory reset the sensor. And then you have Info, where you can find some further information on the SM sensor. And then you have your Output 1 menu, Output 2 menu, and your CFG menu, which is Configuration. Once you're at the menu you want to go into, you can press Enter. So in the Configuration menu is where you can find UNI.F, which is where you will set your flow units, and you have UNI.T, which is where you can set your temperature units. So first I'm going to go into UNI.F by highlighting it and pressing Enter. Here you can see it is set for liters per minute. If you hold down either the up or down arrow key, you'll see the bar load, and then you're able to toggle through your different options. So in this video, I'm going to change it from liters per minute to gallons per minute. So once you're at the parameter you want to set, you press Enter, and then you're back in the configuration menu. So then I will go down to UNI.T and press Enter, and I'll change it from Celsius to Fahrenheit by holding down either the up or down arrow key, letting the bar load, and then you can toggle through your options. So once you're on Fahrenheit, you can press Enter. So now if I take you back to the main display by pressing the down key till you're at the main display, you can see that the flow rate shows gallons per minute now, temperature is in Fahrenheit, and your totalizer value is in gallons. So now let me take you back into the menu by pressing this Enter button. We'll go back into the extended functions menu by going to EF and pressing Enter. And now if you go into the Output 1 menu, for example, you can see all of the parameters specific for Output 1. Output 1 can be set to monitor either flow or temperature using the SEL1 parameter. Here you have OU1, where you can set it for your different switching outputs, which are defined on the Learn More page. And here you have your SP1 and RP1 parameters that you can go into and set. So now if I go back into the extended functions menu and go down to the Output 2 menu and press Enter, in here you can see all of the parameters specific for Output 2. As you can see, it is factory set for flow, and the output is set for I, which is the analog output, and which is why you see ASP2 and AEP2 as your parameter sets here. So for example, ASP2 is your analog start point, which would represent your 4 milliamps, and AEP2 is analog endpoint, which represents your 20 milliamps. So there you have it. That's how you can manually program the SM sensor using the display and push buttons. And that concludes this Tech Insights video on the programming of our SM series flow sensors. As always, you can go to our Learn More page to find helpful information on any of our products. Feel free to contact us at our service center at 1-800-441-8246 if you have any further questions. Thank you for your time and have a great day.